Hi. Hello, hello, hello. Welcome back to my channel. If you don't know me, my name is Sosa, and I'm an engineer that talks about engineering things and whatever else that might fall under that umbrella, including computer science. We are going to be talking about some beginner steps to get into coding and programming and computer science basics and things like that. I keep getting a lot of comments and questions with people asking me how to get started, and I completely get it. Computer science and programming and coding in general can seem very intimidating and really daunting to get into. There's so many resources that it can feel really overwhelming. And so in this video, I kind of just want to lay out some basic steps for any beginner to take to get their feet wet in learning about coding and learning about computer science fundamentals and to get you started. So let's jump right into it. So before you even jump into programming, the first thing you want to ask yourself is why you want to do it. Why do you want to become a programmer? Why do you want to learn how to code? Ask yourself real questions and be honest with yourself. Is it because you want to make a career change? Is it because you just want to pick up a new skill that you think is interesting? Are you trying to build the next Spotify application? Asking yourself these questions will really help gauge which programming language you should start off with and how much time commitment you have to put into what you want to do later on. And whatever your reason is for wanting to learn how to code, it is completely valid. But just know, obviously, coding is not easy. It's something that you have to put in the work into to understand. Maybe you're a genius and you can pick it up overnight. That's cool. But for me and other people like me, it takes some time. It takes some effort. And so you just have to be honest with yourself and be willing to ask yourself the question of whether or not you want to put in this amount of effort into learning it. Do some more research and decide what field of engineering you'd want to contribute to and what type of coding work you'd want to do. If you just want to build a website, then that's web development. If you want to build a mobile app, if you want to do databases or data science and machine learning, figure out which field you want to start in, and then from there, you can then tackle which programming language you want to learn. And so after you figured out which field you want to do, and if you don't even know which field you want to do, that's fine too. So once you figure out what you want to code, you can easily pinpoint which programming language to learn. For example, if you just wanted to build a website, then you can start with HTML and CSS. And then from there, you can then learn JavaScript. And there are a bunch of interactive online websites where they will guide you step by step through programming languages or through projects for you to build and teach you about said language. So for example, a resource like Free Code Camp is interactive and kind of guides you through building a website or building a bunch of different projects. But I think their baseline is being able to build a website. And they kind of teach you how to do that step by step by first teaching you HTML and then teaching you CSS, and then you go into JavaScript. I'll have all of the resources that I talk about in this video listed below so that you can easily go to them on your free time. And so there's not one best programming language to learn or to start off learning. But I always say that Python is by far probably the easiest language to start with. It's very beginner friendly. It almost reads like English when you look at Python code. So it's a lot easier for beginners to pick up. And for Python, there are so many online resources that you can look into. There's Code Academy and some other resources that I'll list in my description below. So if you don't know yet what you want to build, like if you don't know if you want to build a website, if you don't know if you want to build an application, if you don't know if you want to build a web app and you just know that you want to learn how to code, I think the first step is looking into the resources that I have down below and checking out Python and starting with that. Because there are so many resources out there, there are so many books, there are so many articles, there are so many sources that you can use to learn Python or any other language, but if you're not really applying what you're learning, at least for me, I'm a person who learns through doing. And so if I'm not actively doing something, if I'm not actively writing a for loop, if I'm not actively setting up a web page, then I'm not really gonna soak in the knowledge that I'm learning from these articles or videos or whatever else that I'm reading. Step two is to focus on computational thinking and problem solving. So when you're looking at all of these tutorials online, a lot of them teach you how to do specific things and teach you about the programming language itself and not really bigger concepts or bigger things that you really should be learning about. So for this step, it might be really helpful to take an online course. Tutorials aren't really going to teach you because they're going to be very specific on the programming language at hand and not really the overarching concepts that an engineer should know in any programming language that they pick up.
Hi, I know I look crazy, but I'm editing right now and I realized that I forgot to mention what these core concepts are, and I've talked about them in multiple videos that I'll link down below. But these core concepts that I was talking about have to do with algorithms, data structures, things like that. These are fundamentals of computer science that you will still need to pick up or learn on your own if you're self-learning. When you want to do programming and when you're in the very beginning, it's much easier to learn these concepts now when you're just starting than to try to fit them in later on when you're stuck. And so really making sure that you have the fundamentals down pat is essential for being an engineer that's able to adapt to all of the different things thrown at you. It doesn't matter what programming language you end up picking up, you will always need these fundamentals in data structures, algorithms, and in problem solving / critical thinking skills. They'll always be essential to the job that you're doing, to the work that you're doing, to the project that you're building. But I just wanted to lay that out as to the things that I'm talking about in this section are algorithms, data structures, problem solving, critical thinking. All right, back to the video.
And so the faster and quicker that you learn these key concepts, it'll be way easier to pick up programming languages later on. And these concepts, as I've said in multiple other videos, you're going to need them no matter what language you end up picking up. You're going to have to use them at some point, so might as well learn them in the beginning once you first start out so that you're not blocked later down the line. One resource that I've seen on this that helps so many other engineers, and I haven't taken it myself because you guys know I went to school and I got my bachelor's degree in computer science, so these like key concepts in school because it was just required for the major. For people who are self-learning, I've heard that Harvard's CS50X Intro to Computer Science course is really, really, really good for learning some of these really important topics like data structures and algorithms. I've only seen good reviews about the class. I think it'll be really, really helpful to take a class like this when you're learning how to program because it'll really help solidify some key concepts that you'll need. I can link that class in my description below. For this step, don't be hyper-focused on a singular programming language. Just because you're learning Python does not mean that you will ever only use Python moving forward. You want to be able to adapt and change as projects go on. And the only way to do that is by really solidifying your foundations. Step three, this is a short one. Start watching some videos on coding. Sometimes it's just easier to watch other people and see how they do it. I do this all the time when I want to pick up a new language. Right now I'm working on building out a web app and I'm using React in JavaScript, and in school I did not learn anything about that or anything about those languages or front end in general. I didn't learn in school. I kind of had to go back and again, like going through these steps that I've already listed, like, okay, what do I want to build? I want to build a web app to help high school students. Okay, what programming languages does that involve? Oh, that involves HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Cool, let's look at some really important concepts that I need to know for understanding JavaScript. Okay, well, I've already have that kind of checked off because of my background in CS. If I didn't, then I'd just go back and make sure to look into resources. Okay, after that step, I have no idea how to even approach JavaScript or React. What are my first steps? So I started with watching videos on YouTube of people just setting up simple React projects. After watching a couple, I kind of was able to understand a pattern of how React apps are built, and then looking through Medium articles and blog posts and things like that. And after doing it consistently for a while and watching these videos, I was able to kind of understand, you know, how React worked, how JavaScript works and things like that. And because I already have knowledge from other programming languages that I knew, it made things a lot easier. YouTube videos are a great way to learn how to code. Maybe looking into people who are building simpler apps, like just the to-do list, start with that. Step four, don't get caught up in the tutorial loop. So as I was saying earlier, when I want to learn something new, I look at videos, I look at tutorials, and I kind of go through those continuously so that I can pick up a pattern and be able to apply this in real life and build my own things. You don't want to get caught up in only doing tutorials and never really applying anything that you've learned. make sure that you're applying what you're learning by building out smaller projects. So whether it's following along with the YouTube video and building your own thing on the side, or just like literally not necessarily copying and pasting what they're doing, but like literally typing as they type, like building things as they're building it, like it'll really help you solidify your understanding of what's going on. Maybe you're not even thinking about getting a job later on. So maybe you're just thinking about presenting things to your friends or building an app or just being able to show somebody or show yourself that you're able to get things done. The best way to do that is to directly apply your knowledge, directly apply the skills that you're learning by building out a small portfolio of things. If it's just a calculator, if it's just a to-do app, whatever that is, start to create a portfolio of projects that you can then present to whoever. And then you want that you have these skills that you've learned after all the tutorials and after all the articles and all the readings. Now you have a final tangible project that you'd be able to show anyone and say, hey, I built this. Did this. So personal projects are just a proof of your coding skills, and they're really important to have, especially when you're self-learning, because you really want to be able to put pen to paper and say, not only did I pick up these new skills, but I was then able to apply it and build something, and here is that something. Some other smaller tips: celebrate small victories. So if you're able to do a hello world on a web page, celebrate that, because that's awesome. A lot of people don't make it to that stage. Coding is not easy, and a lot of people give up before they even start because they think that they can't do it. It's really important to continue to self-motivate and celebrate any type of wins, small or large, that you end up having. Another small tip: whenever you get an error, Google it, because you're probably not the first one to get that error. Literally all you have to do, and I do this all the time on the app that I'm building right now with React, I'll get a lot of errors that I literally do not understand, and so I will just copy paste that into Google, and usually 99% of the time I'll see that somebody else made this error and like find a solution to it. And then last thing, don't be afraid to ask somebody to look at your code. It's a learning moment for not only you, but then the person who is looking at your code. If you're not doing best practices, somebody else can be able to look into what you're doing and say, hey, maybe you can do this a little better. You can probably optimize this function a little bit better, things like that. It might be harder when you're self-learning, but if you're working on like a bigger project, or if you're contributing to open source projects, peer reviewing is just another way of learning. If you have the opportunity, try to do that. So those are all of my tips, and I hope that wasn't too overwhelming. I hope I was able to break that down as best as I can. Again, I'm gonna link all of the resources down below of things sites I was talking about. Again, I know that this whole process can be extremely daunting, but it's really important to take it step by step so that learning all of this doesn't become overwhelming. Leave me a comment if you have any other questions or things that I didn't answer. Again, I hope you liked the video. I will see you in the next one. Don't forget to like and subscribe.